In part three, we're going to sweep this circle up at an angle to avoid the ugly shaped solid that extruding straight up would do. And to sweep, we need a sweep direction, and for that we need a plane to sketch on that has the line of sweep, and it'll be a plane 22.5 degrees offset from this, so we'll go new plane, and that plane as a rotation about x of 22.5, and that would be this plane, so we'll generate, and then when we pick that plane to sketch on, we want to sketch a line that goes from the circle up at an angle. The circle's back here, so we're going to just sketch in a line a bit like that. We'll drag it around later when we can see this circle. So there's that circle, and if we just get a good reference on where that circle is, and that circle say starts near the edge of the screen there, and then go back to our sketch 18. So yeah, that's a pretty good direction, and we're going to maybe just drag that around a little. So modify drag, can grab a point and drag an end, so we don't want it to be too steep. We can drag that around a little more. This is not to an exact dimension, so we'll just see what it looks like when we take sketch 7 and sweep the sketch, which is the profile, along the path, which is sketch 18, and we slice material with as a thin surface with no offset and no merge topology. Let's take a look at that, and that's come through quite nicely. So now if we pick the if we pick this body and hide all other bodies, that is potentially meshable after I merge those two faces. We'll have a nice hex mesh above the critical zone, and we'll have a nice hex mesh in the layer just above the wall. So that is good, and let's show all bodies and see where we are now. I think we'll want to do some merging again. I've shown that already, so I'll just stop the video and do that offline and see what's happening in part 4.